Suttle Academy sponsored online faculty development program on wearable devices organized by Center for Medical Electronics, Anna University, Chennai. It was rightly said that the greatest of resources is humankind by itself. In this FDP, we are coming across such eminent resourceful personalities who, in spite of being in a virtual setting, felicitated us in acquiring brand new knowledge. In tune with this great initiative, we have with us today another eminent speaker who shall share her knowledge on this FDP topic. It is indeed a great pleasure for me to introduce our speaker for the session, Ms. Meenu M. Pillai. Ms. Meenu is a product design strategist at Squid Design and the head designer of utility soft product design at Kerrymore, Bangalore. She is also a digital design visiting faculty at NIFT Bhubaneswar and user experience design consultant of medical apparel at Xfinito Biodesign. She has a wide experience as a designer with top clothing companies like Techport Syndicate and Wildcraft, to name a few. She did her bachelor's in textile technology and master's in apparel design. While pursuing her master's program at National Institute of Design, she designed a fire suit garment for Formula One motorsports drivers, focusing on both comfort and fire safety. This is considered to be a great contribution since there are no manufacturers for racing suit in India. She has been awarded the All India Best Designer Award for Women Active Wear by Arvind Lifestyle and Best Startup Pitch Idea by National Institute of Design. Today, for this online FTP on wearable devices, Ms. Meenu will be presenting on the topic Smart Textiles. I believe that with her wide research experience and accolades in textile, she is the apt resource person to deliver a talk for the same. I, on behalf of Center for Medical Electronics, Anna University, welcome you, ma'am. The session is all yours, ma'am.
Thank you so much. Thank you for the intro. So now I don't have to introduce myself. Thank you. So I would like to add a few more parts into it, that I was working into advanced material division, which is more into smart textile. I have around 7 years of experience in smart textile. I worked with more of the advanced material division department. So advanced material division, they handle smart textiles. So we have few in our country, that is TaraSafe, advanced material division, and Texport, where Texport I was working as a chief designer and product strategist. So in this company, I was developing, working more for army protective gears and industrial protective gear. Luckily, I get to work for Navy, Army, and other protective segments. So I'm getting into the topic smart textile. So shall I start?
Yes, ma'am.
So I wanted to start with the basic, because smart textile nowadays, it is having so many definitions. So I just wanted to ensure that we are aligned in the same page. I just wanted to excuse us. If you are getting some vehicle noise, kindly ignore, because I am staying just beside the road. And if you are getting any devotional music behind, I am staying beside a temple, so it might come in between. Apologies. And whenever you have to ask any sort of questions, kindly raise your question. Anytime I will be explaining the process for developing smart textile based product as well. So while explaining the process also, if you have any sort of questions in between, please raise your voice, or you can use the chat board for asking the question. So I will be answering accordingly. So I wanted to start with the basic, which is smart textile, because nowadays there are a lot many definitions which is in the industry for smart textile. I just wanted to ensure that we are aligned, that I will be explaining based on this. So smart textile is a major segment of electronic textile along with smart clothing and wearable computer, so which contains electronic components in it, and it will be performing a sort of function. So it is mostly made into a textile-based product or integrated into a textile. Based on its functionality, it can sense, react, adapt themselves according to a different environment. So based on their functionality, the smart textile is divided into two categories. One is passive smart textile and another one is active smart textile. So passive smart textile, we all know about it. We have experienced and maybe one among us now wearing and sitting with that. So it is sort of first generation computer. So I can call Parcel Smart Textile as first generation smart textile because its functionality is little more than, little beyond than what we currently wear. So you might have heard about antibacterial, anti-odor, anti-static. So little enhanced bulletproof, plasma treated clothing, fabric with optical sensor. So all this comes under this passive wearable technology. If getting into active wearable technology, so there are, it is little more advanced. So it can, it is sort of automated. It can adapt and change their functionality according to the environment or according to the need of the user with a remote control or with a application attached to it. So there are different definitions for smart textile. I will be explaining further things based on this. So I wanted to introduce one of our successfully commercialized product, which is in the category of smart textile. It is a safety gear for cyclists. So it will be giving indications based on turning right, turning left, or braking. So it is having lighting embedded to it. It will be having sensor and a control unit in their hand, in the form, in their hand or in the cycle. So here is the product. So it comes, it is amalgam of active and passive smart textile, which is one of our successful product. So let's listen to how others are describing this smart textile. As I mentioned, it is having multiple definitions. Here I have one, Mr. David Vigano, co-founder and CEO of Sensoria. According to him, smart textile is equal to future of wearable technology. In his company, he is collaborating fashion and technology, where he is replacing all plastic sensors into textile-based sensor. So this textile-based sensors are comfortable, it is durable, it is as functional as this plastic sensors. So as I said, the smart textile, it is having n number of definition according to its functioning. So previously, smart textile were presented in imaginary product. I do remember in my college days, in my post-graduation day, whenever I wanted to present something based on, I wanted to do something, some project based on smart textile, I was not having a product. Everything was images or it was sketches or it was a concept. It was because that time it was limited in area. No much areas goes into the smart textile, but after scientific effort and allotment development phases, nowadays smart textile are implanted customer interest. So in so currently smart textile is projected as future of textile industry. So many commercial products are available in the market which is based on smart textile. So I would like to introduce one more our project, which is currently we are in the development process. So this is also amalgam of active and passive smart textile. It is very simple belt, which is being worn by pregnant women. Their hand gesture, if they are rubbing their hands over the belt, they can get the imagery of baby. So it is not replacement of scanner. So it is compactable and cost effective ultrasound scanning technology, which is developed for rural areas where infant fetuses are dying in the mother's womb itself, for tracking and better providing them better health suggestions. We developed this for portable, compactable and cost effective ultrasound scanning technology using this, using Doppler scanning method. So this scanner can not, this scanner not only gives imagery based on your baby's position, it also helps to track the blood flow of the fetus, oxygen availability, nutrients needed, their stretching posture, breathing, availability of sun, heart rate. Again, I'm saying it is not replacement of doctor or the traditional ultrasonography. So this is one of our project which is channelized. I wanted to highlight this product because you just name one technology. We have an alternate replacement of smart textile for the same technology. So is smart textile? Is smart textile always complicated with signal processing software and sensor? So I am asking all these questions so that everyone can relate with what next I am explaining. If you have questions, please raise. I will be asking question and I am answering it myself. So is smart textile always complicated? No, it is not. So have you heard about cooling fabric? Anyone heard about cooling fabric? Okay, yeah, someone might have heard about it and few might not. So cooling fabric, by hearing about it, you might feel it is fabric form of air conditioning with lots of devices and all. No, it is not. It is very simple, daily usable smart textile based on few technologies. Here you can see one image. The cooling fabric technology is based on...
Can you increase your volume? I mean, your voice is very low.
Okay, one minute. Now, can you hear?
Yeah, now it is better.
Okay. So you couldn't hear any of those? Should I repeat anything?
No, we were able to hear. Only thing, the volume was little less. That's it.
Okay. Yeah, fine. Okay. So this is one of the simple yet smarter smart textile. So which we can use it for everyday use. It is having some functionality inbuilt to it. Basic physics is giving the cooling effect. You might have heard about convection. So convection is basic heat transfer method. So when there is a bulk movement of molecules within fluid, there will be a heat transfer. So that thermobuffering releases heat from your body. That gives the cooling effect. So basic science is used in this product for achieving the cooling effect. So this product is being used in sportswear industry the most. So smart textile can be as simple as this product as well. So next is how to consider smart textile while developing a product. So I wanted to explain more about smart textile. I want to give more and more examples about smart textile. Then I realized whatever I explain, how much ever I explain, it will be the same thing. Based on depending on the product, the functionality will be varying. So I don't want to do that. I wanted to explain how it is possible to develop a product based on smart textile. So you have to go through a few of the basic process for developing, for achieving a smart textile based product. So everyone know the reality that you will not be getting smart textile readily available from the market. You have to develop it according to your requirement and according to the functionality you want it to perform. So when we get into product, smart textile is based on its functionality. So it is important to understand and what functionality is required. Also, the functionality is depending on the solutioning which you are giving. The solution always connected with the problem area. So these are the three building stones for developing a product based on smart textile. So you have to have understanding of this three parameters. So I will be explaining these three parameters based on a successful project that is Formula One Racing Suit. So Formula One Racing Suit, you know what it is as in the introduction, how they were explaining. So Formula One Racing Suit is a car racing. So it is the highest level car racing. I'm just explaining about the basics of it. So the driver race about in the speed of 375 kilometers per hour. The adventurous and the risk behind it is really high. So safety regulations are also really high. Why Formula One Racing Suit? Because It is amalgam of passive and active smart textiles, plus involvement of smart textile is in the sense many varieties of smart textile is used in this clothing for creating it. Also, smart textile is having a major role in this product. So I wanted to explain Formula One racing suit. So if you're looking at the imageries, the first image is of Naren Karthikeyan. Hope you all know about Naren Karthikeyan. He is India's first Formula One racer based in Coimbatore. So so let's get into the process of developing this Formula One racing suit, which is smart textile based product. So I was looking at the problem area. So there are different methods for looking at the problem areas. So you can interact with the user, you can experience it, or you can get into all the research part of it. For example, Formula One is a higher level project for interacting with the user or experiencing it might take long duration. So if your project is of short duration, interacting with and getting in touch with the user will not be possible. If it is some other project, you can always note down your experience, what you're going through, what all problem you're facing while handling or while doing such sort of activity. So you can figure out there is a need and these are all the problem. That is one way by experiencing. And second way is you can always interact with the user. You can always connect with the user. It is sort of empathy sharing. So you can ask questions, you can be around them, you can observe them, you can through interaction, through looking at them. So ethnography is one model. So there are different methods for collecting information based on the user and what all problem they are facing. In the case of Formula One, there was no such resources. I cannot experience it because it was a 6 months project and I cannot interact with the racing people. I tried Naren Karthikeyan. I tried to interact with Naren Karthikeyan. No one was available at that point of time, and they are people with busy schedules. They will not be having time for discussion and all. So there was no such resources for me to understand problem areas. Then I opted for research. So I was following all these Formula One drivers and their activities. So there are forums where they share about their experience. There are YouTube videos. There are blogs which they wrote about their experience. I was collecting, I was reading through it, and I watched Formula One racing, and I was collecting problem areas through observation. And Formula One racing is not a new launch product. So it was having, it is a renovation, or I was trying to improve it. So it was having previous case studies based on Formula One product development. And I was going through all those case studies and all. I collected almost all the problems what the Formula One drivers are facing. So you can see it's a lot. It was even more than that. So if you're getting lot many problem areas, you don't have to worry about, you don't have to get confused. Okay, this many problems, is it really there or not? So you have to collect all the problem areas. So here few problem areas what Formula One racers faced is, I will read it out so that we can connect it with further slides. So hard to maintain cockpit position. So cockpit is where Formula One drivers sit. So they always have to maintain one position. So they have specific requirement for maintaining that position. Their temperature inside cockpit is 60 degrees Celsius. According to countries, it varies. So temperature is high. So reduces 4 kg after a race. So Formula One racers, they race for 2 hours. So after 2 hours of race, they will be reducing around 4 kg. So they cannot drink water. So there is possibility for dehydration, or if they are drinking water, they cannot afford accumulating water in their urine bladder because they cannot afford increasing the weight. So weight is a constraint. Even 0.01 gram increase in the weight will show the difference in their speed, in their performance and all. and they are having extreme physical movements. G-force is high. So these are a few of the problem areas I tracked by through all the resources which I mentioned before. Then after tracking all the problem areas, I tried to study these problem areas. There were other fields who were facing the same problem areas. For example, fighter jet in Navy. So Navy fighter jet flyer, they will be facing the same G-force. So further, I studied about all those problem areas. Then I segregated it. I segregated few of the problem areas into physical, few into anthropometric, few into physical, few into working environment, and few into ergonomics. So this helped me to organize. This helped me to understand, okay, there are regional based, there are movement based, there are environment based issues. So this helped me to organize and analyze, organize and help me for better analysis of this problem areas. So these are the problem areas in short. There are many more. I am just highlighting few of it. When I explained about the first constraint, that the cockpit position, this is the cockpit position, their psychological, they have to handle so many things. They have to struggle a lot. They will be shedding around 4 to 5 liters of sweat. So these are the problem areas what they are facing. So I now aware about the problem areas what they are facing. Then further I studied about each and every problem. As I said that I further studied about, I interacted with other field people who are facing the same problem. So G-force is one of the problem. Then I further studied about G-force. So I am taking few of the examples and explaining, because it takes days and days when I have to explain each and everything of it. So G-force, then I studied G-force effects on human. It is user behavior. So each and every problem, how the person is going through it, how it is affecting his body, how I can connect each and every problem areas to the user body, to the user behavior. So I was studying further about the problem areas connecting with the user body. So for example, I was talking about G-force. I started tracking which all muscles is being affected by G-force. Can I highlight it? I mapped it. So I mapped all the G-force affecting muscles. Then vibration, that is another issue what they were facing. When they race in the speed of 375 kilometer per hour speed, the vibration what they will be going through is really high, and there are specific muscles which has been affected, and that can cause distraction to the drivers, that can lead to perform little worse than without vibration. So then I tracked the sweat pattern. So I said they will be shedding around 4 to 5 liters of sweat in 2 hours of racing in the speed of 375 kilometer per hour. So here I tracked few of the sweat zones, which is the highest area of sweating, which is the lowest area of sweating. So when I was talking about cooling fabric there, so I don't know where I have to use it, but I know there is a requirement of that. So after studying about the sweat pattern and how much, where it is higher, where it is lesser, where I should use, where I should not use. So all those things I can track through this. So I tracked the sweat pattern. Then body movement. As I mentioned, I know what all are the problem areas, and now I have to understand the user. So few of the problem area is caused due to their movement. Few of the problem area is restricting their movement. So I had to understand what all movements they are doing while racing. So I don't have any facility for understanding that. These all are rough sketches, but I have exact measurement of cockpit. I have exact measurement of the position followed by a Formula One racer when they drive the car. So based on those measurements, those mathematical calculations, I derived this movements of body, how much for calculating how much stretch is required, how much fabric I should remove from where there should not be any bulkiness, or where I should add the ventilations. For understanding all those things, there were so many questions. So for you should never ignore any of the questions coming to your mind. Note down each and every question, because answering that question is going to lead to for your solutioning. Next is solutioning. So I understood the problem areas. I understood how it is affecting the person who is the user. So their interaction with or their performance during driving or racing. So I understood all these aspects. Now I have to assume that, okay, I need stretch here. I need something else here. So if 60 degrees Celsius is the heat, so I need a solution for removing the heat. So it can be a cooling jacket. So this is one of the solutioning. Cooling jacket, so we have to always take care of, if you're solving one problem, it should not highlight the other problem. Cooling jacket, if I'm incorporating to it, it should not hinder the fire retardancy, it should not hinder the movement, it should not hinder thickness, so it should not increase the weight. So always better, whenever you are working based on problem areas, whenever you are working based on solutioning, you prefer, you select one big wall, you stick all those problem areas using sticky notes over it, sit in front of that, analyze, do all the activities by keeping everything in front of you. It is always confusing. It is always, there is a chance for missing some of the problem areas, because Formula One is very expensive project. So you have to get funding from an industry for performing this project. You have to go through a lot of research for before coming into the product. After developing the product will be going for testing. So if the testing fails, the possibility for redoing the project is very less, because for testing itself, we have to pay a lot and do test. Before that also, we paid a lot for doing the research work. So we have to be very careful when we are working with such projects, which is of high value. So these are a few of the explorations. So these are a few of the solutioning. I felt it needs stretch. So this entire exploration is based on stretch. So because of this kind of movement, and because of the movements mentioned here, if there is stretch here, it will be helpful. If there is stretch here, it will be helpful. I don't know. I'm not having any sort of final result in this stage, because it is success or not. I have to make different iterations. I have to calculate with all the results and all the information what I am having. I have to create mockups. I have to make a person sit and turn, twist in this degree, and look at the possibilities of it. So these are the things what I have done. So I try to understand problem areas. I try to connect it with the user body. I try to create solutioning, that is ideation. So after doing all this, you can get into the fabric part of it. Is the presentation still there on the screen?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Oh, 1 minute. 2:30. So before getting into fabric functioning, so I would like to hear any questions regarding that. Do you have any questions based on the process?
You can have the question and answer session at the end of your presentation.
Okay. Okay, fine. So next is functioning. So based on the problem areas which you noted down, you have a calculation that okay, this should be the solutioning. After analyzing the problem areas in regard with the user, Then you try to create solutioning for that. Now it is, now the textile, smart textile part is coming into picture, that is functioning. So when we get into the problem areas, I haven't explained this fire. So all racing suit is fire retardant, because when there is an accident, there is a possibility for catching fire, and the temperature can go around 3000 degrees Celsius. So all the fire, all the racing suit should be fire retardant. So here you can see functioning of the garment. So the garment is of three layers. Each layer is embroidered, each layer is having some sort of functioning, which is high level of smart textile. So these are passive smart textile. The external layer is passive smart textile, and when they are racing in like minus degree regions, then that time they will be using some sort of active textile for regulating their temperature. So now I am talking about one layer of the garment, that is the external layer. So when the garment comes in contact with, so each layer is having its own functionality. So the external layer, when the garment comes in contact with fire, so the external layer starts reacting and it starts creating char, which is one form of carbon. So each fiber of this garment creates char, which is sort of creating kind of barrier. So after development of, after formation of char, which is brittle and strong, it doesn't allow any further penetration of oxygen and other heat molecules to further layers of this garment. So the external layer, when it interacts with fire, it gets converted to char, it gets converted to a barrier, which is brittle and stiff when it is cold. So further layers will be protected for number of seconds. So every garment will, every layer will perform for specific number of seconds. So after that many duration of time, first layer will go off, then fire will be on next layer. So each and every layer of this garment is having its own way of functioning. So second layer will be having nanofiber, which is hollow nanofibers in the form of felt. So hollow nanofibers captures maximum amount of air into it. So in physics, 7th or 8th grade, we have studied when air molecules comes in contact with heat, its velocity goes down and it flies up. So here also the same mechanism gets applied. When the air is in contact with heat, air will not stay for transferring the heat to the next molecule, it will fly away. So air captured within the second layer will keep flying away, will keep taking away the heat from that and resisting or not transferring the heat to next layer. So each and every layer in this garment is having a functionality, higher level functionality. And higher level. So okay. So after considering the textile part, smart textile part, Formula One. Okay, I forgot to introduce this part. Formula One racing suit is strictly followed by rules and regulation. So it is having a set of standards to be followed, a set of rules and regulations to be followed. So Formula One racing suit, it will be having parameters of rules and regulation for choosing the smart textile, for construction, for testing, for wearing, and there are many other parameters based on the regulation. So construction is one of the major regulation. So whichever smart textile you are choosing, it might be supporting your problem areas, it might be supporting the solutioning what you are suggesting, but it might not be supporting the construction parameters, then that will lead to failure. So you have to look at the construction parameters as well while choosing the smart textiles. So which has been the construction parameters has been provided by regulatory bodies. And here is the construction parameter. So while doing such regulatory based project, you cannot change many of the areas. So your innovation in this will be limited. So being within that limitation, you have to innovate. You can innovate in layering. You can innovate. You cannot change construction technique. It is possible to change. It is, no one is restricting that. So when you change any constructional parameter in this, any smart textile parameter in that, so you have to prove it by developing test methods for it, by developing the sample by yourself, creating a certificate. So for all this long way, it even have to. So once such kind of innovation happened, you created something new, you created something innovative, you wanted to change something which gives better than current one. So there will be change in the regulation as well. So you have to be, when we work with such project, there is a big limitation, that is the regulation. So we have to innovate whatever it is within, by staying within the limitation. So this is Formula One racing. So can we get into question section, or you have?
Yeah. Participants are allowed to unmute their mic and you can ask any doubts.
Any question regarding smart textile product development? So this is one. So I wanted to explain smart textile product development based on Formula One racing suit because it is my personal experience and I have interacted with industries. I have collaborated with industries. The product is developed. It went for testing. So I know the entire process behind it. And smart textile is playing very major role in the specific project. How much ever the innovation is, how much ever the solution is going to be, and is functioning. So smart textile is having real important role in this project. So I wanted to explain about Formula One racing suit in regard with smart textile. So I haven't touched many of the basic parts of it, like how we can embed smart textiles, we can into a textile. So how we can convert or how we can develop smart textile using printing, embroidery, using weaving with conductive thread. So all this part I haven't explained it because I know all is aware of all such basics of it. So any questions regarding the process for developing a smart textile, which is problem area, functionality, and solutioning? Or you want to share something?
Meenu ma'am, it was very nice. You explained very clearly the steps wise how the problem you approached and how you micromanaged or how you split into small chunks and then worked on that. It was very nice and how you come out with the solution. But what is the current status of your project? How is that? Can you give some idea about that? How is your project? What is the results and what is the end results and how it is now? What stage it is now?
Yeah. So this project was in it was part of Make in India movement. It was in collaboration with Aravind. Aravind sponsored this project. So Aravind, DuPont and NID is in picture. So DuPont was giving us technical inputs, the head of DuPont, technical head of DuPont, and Aravind sponsored the project. So we developed the product, sent it for testing, and currently we are selling Formula One Balaclava, the inner garment of it. So Formula One is three layer one piece garment, and they have a inner garment. So inner garment is sold by Aravind now in market.
So basically it's a cooling one or a cooling jacket kind, or what is that?
No, so we don't so the inner is a comfort wear, sort of like how we wear inner garment. So it protects your skin. It is sort of second skin. It is not cooling. It is when it is not active, it is passive cooling technology.
It's like a thermal wear, what you're talking, right? In the normal sense, if I say it's a thermal wear kind, not exactly.
There will not be temperature. If it is required for temperature regulation, it is kind of thermal wear, knitted thermal wear. It looks like that. Functioning will be different.
Okay.
So if you want to see that, I have, I think I have images of that. Can you see the screen?
No, we can able to see only your presentation.
Okay.
What was the length of the project? Is it 2 years or 3 years?
It was 6 months project.
Okay.
Yeah, I will share it again. So here you can see a few of the iterations, and can you see the undergarment here?
Yeah.
So it is sort of thermal, but by considering ergonomics, and it is having little more functionality than a thermal wear. So we have different iteration explorations, and we chosen one. So is there any other question?
Ma'am, that was a great project that you have done. I've just got a question. Like, what is the material that has been used for designing this garment?
Okay, there are different material which is going into it. It is three layer garment. So I can take you to the page as well. So it is having percentage of Nomex, percentage of Kevlar, and percentage of anti-static. So it is combination of different materials.
Okay.
The material property gives you the reduction in the temperature?
No. In what case? If it is, okay. There is one problem faced by Formula One racing, that is 60 degrees Celsius. You are asking about that, right?
Yes.
Yeah. So body's normal nature is for reducing the temperature is sweating. So during this time, Formula One racing driver, they sweat 6 to 7 liters of, they shed 6 to 7 liters of sweat. So they automatically cooling their body by sweating. Now we have to manage the sweat. So I explained that cooling garment, sorry, cooling fabric, right? in using convection method, it will be transporting the heat. So the same technology is being used here as well. So I will show you that in the presentation. 1 minute. Can you see the presentation now? No, right?
No.
Okay. Now can you see the presentation? Yeah. So I explained this cooling fabric based on convection. So this smart textile technology is being used in Formula One racing suit as well for cooling. For reducing temperature, for reducing weight of the garment, so we cannot afford adding too much of weight by putting electronic devices inside it. So there is one company called Lumia who is developing flexible, active smart textile. But there is few limitation for getting approval in the from the certification body. So we are following the same tradition of convection cooling. There is no other cooling devices which is incorporated with it. Yeah, any other question? Is that clear?
How about the testing, ma'am? What are the things you have considered while testing the suit?
Okay. While testing the suit, there are two different ways of testing. One is user testing, because I incorporated lot many experimental parts over it. That is the stretch panels and all. So I will take you through that presentation. So, yeah. So I have incorporated so many stress panels and all over here. For testing those, if I made it a person wear it and we achieved the same degree of cockpit measurement, if the driver is sitting inside a racing car, how they will be sitting. So all the stretch panels, each and every stretch panel is tested by doing the same activity. So here you can see that. So that is one test method, that is user testing. So if you are asking the product testing, so there are testing bodies based on the regulation. So for Formula One racing, we follow FIA regulation. So they have their own testing bodies. So we will be sending the garment for those testing through some agencies.
Thank you.
What are the currently available suits for the Formula One races?
What are
they? Is available in the market? Currently available suits.
So all suits, it should fall under the regulation. So it doesn't have a specific name for that suit, and it is not openly available in the market. You have to
function wise or
okay,
they currently use
So function wise, it is fire retardant, it is anti-static, and it will be absorbing sweat. It is it is impact resistant, it is cut resistant, and I think that's all. And all these garments, when garment interact with fire, it creates poisonous fumes. So this garments doesn't create poisonous fumes when they burn. So all these parameters been considered. So yeah.
These are all passive suits, no, ma'am?
Yeah, these all are passive. So
what about active?
Yeah, active when it depends on. So every time others raising happens in different countries. So if the race happens in a cold minus degree country, then they will be using a heating device. So which is incorporated with their undergarment, it will be regulating the temperature. So this specific suit is developed based on 60 degrees Celsius. So we have to specify that which country and where it will be racing. So when we develop a suit, and all the suits are custom made. Each and every suit, if you are one of the Formula One racer, that suit will be made based on your measurements. You cannot purchase and you cannot fit that one. It is custom made.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you. Any other question?
Ma'am, it was a very interesting presentation, ma'am. Ma'am, I have a question. Like, yeah. Can you just explain active and passive textile?
Huh. Yes. So, should I go back to the presentation? So, verbally is enough. So, active, passive textile, have you used any of the sportswear garments, t-shirts and all, which doesn't smell, and when you sweat, it dries out easily. So have you used any such garments?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah, so those are our passive smart textile, so which will be having some inherent or chemically treated functionality to it. So active textile is a smart textile which is more advanced than that. It can adapt and change its functionality. It can even respond to external environment, or if you want to change some parameters in your active smart textile, you can do that as well. So it is advanced level of smart textile, active.
Okay, ma'am.
Okay.
Nitisha, you can conclude now.
Okay, ma'am. Thank you, ma'am, Mamino, ma'am, for a beautiful presentation on smart textile. It was really interesting. We got to know about what are smart textiles and the other products in that. The most interesting for us was how to take up a project, and mainly the way you explained the smart textile for a Formula One racing suit. It started with identifying the problem areas and analyzing it, defining the concepts, functioning, regulation, each and everything was beautifully presented. It is actually inspiring for young researchers of how to look, take up a project and how to move forward. Thank you so much, ma'am, for the interesting presentation.
Thank you. Thank you so much for your patience and for the opportunity. It was energizing to interact with you guys.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you. So can I leave, or how it should be?
Yeah, you can leave.
Thank you. Thank you so much.
Thank you. Participants, tomorrow, the day 4 of our FDP on wearable devices will begin at 9:30. You can join using the same link. If you have any queries, kindly drop a mail at wearabledevices2020@gmail.com. You'll receive the feedback link for today's session. It will be emailed by evening to your registered email ID. Kindly submit the same. Recorded videos of today's session will also be sent along with it. Thank you, and we'll meet up tomorrow. Bye.
Well, if you join by 9:15 as you joined today to avoid the connectivity issues.
Tomorrow we have two talks from USA. One first session is from Arizona State University, Professor Thurman Lockhart. And second session is from University of California, San Diego, Mr. Sundar Raman. So please join for both the sessions. And in the afternoon, you have a very interesting session, which is a general talk. How to get freed from psychological problems using scientific methods, which is a general talk. So kindly join for all the three sessions. Please join at 9:15 tomorrow. Thank you.